Welcome to Landria, Onkka on YouTube, here to help you break through those fears and live an awesome life. Check my .com site. You know how to spell my name. It's on the YouTube channel, Landria, Onkka. I have a .com and a .net. Go check them out. One's my spiritual mentoring. At some point, you'll go over there and I'll actually have my online courses up and running. I'm working on that. So I want to talk to you today about when I get comments coming over, I want you to understand, because I know you hear me say that everything's exactly the way it should be. What does that mean? Something's happening I don't like. That should be? Really, Landria? Yeah. So somebody asked, why am I attracting this stuff? Everything is for you. None of this is random. Everything's planned. Your higher self is actually right now working while you're here. Because there's nothing that's separate. You are all of that that's over there. You are that. So one of the questions a viewer had is, you know, how can I be all of that? How am I all of that? I don't know how that works. Like, I'm a person, you know, and you're saying that I'm all of those other things. How can that be? Because there's only one energy. Everything, okay, let's talk about the Big Bang. First of all, where did that come from, right? That's ridiculous, but yes, let's say there was one Big Bang because there was a singularity. There was a moment when expansion happened. It continues to expand, by the way. The galaxies are moving away from us faster than the speed of light. So remember that when there was nothing faster than the speed of light? There's no limits. How can there be limits? You know, only humans, okay, here's this, and this is how, you know, oh, there's speed of light's the fastest. No. There are no limits. So guess what? Whoa, there's no limits? Holy cow. You mean that there are beings of every kind that we can communicate without thought, we can just know at each other, or without speech, we can know what each other's feeling, we can levitate things. Yep. Yes, 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 yes. So why doesn't that happen here? We're not on that frequency right now. And also, we came here for a different purpose. We came here to experience being human. So don't get me wrong. There are some restrictions in this role that we play, but there are no limitations. But you didn't come here to just sit around and, you know, be a billionaire and not do anything and fly around the sky and stuff. You can do all that stuff on the other side. You came from that. You came here to experience something very different, the density, and to raise the frequency of this planet that so badly needs it. People are waiting to come in here. Energies are waiting to get here, and you're here. What are you doing with it? What are you doing with your time here? I'm counting on you. Everybody's counting on you. Everybody's cheering. What is that? Wait a minute, Landry, you just said we're one thing. How can I be all those things if they're separate cheering me on? You are that. You're this finger and this, are you this? So if I chopped off a finger, would that finger not be me anymore? How does that work? This is not solid. There's nothing solid. Everything is just one energy, and it's just forming into things and transforming, and then we pass away and we transform, we go out and then we go into something else, or maybe we're a flower. Look at this. Isn't this gorgeous? My friend Allie brought me the most incredible roses for my birthday. Look at this. And then it dies so quickly, but there's no death. It transforms again. It goes into something else. And this has energy. This is a feeling thing, energy. It doesn't think like we do because it's a different form of energy. It feels me. It reacts to me. I think that's why, you know what? Do you know this is like, oh my gosh, it's been 3 weeks that these roses have been still looking beautiful. Why? Because I think it's the energy in this house, right? Things are fresh and new. That's just another energy. So you are an expression in everyone you see, and they are in you. Every thought changes everything. So you're affecting everybody with a thought. All of the energy that you are is on the other side is actually helping you here. I have witnessed recently, because veils are coming down, the energy is shifting, so the density is coming down. That's a good sign. That means that stuff's happening. You might be more sensitive to things, people more irritated than that. All the stuff's bubbling to the top so that we can clear it out. It's not negative. It's not like things are getting worse. It's like, no, things are getting better, because all those things are coming to the top so that we can deal with it. Everything's exactly as it should be. You are all these things. Embrace it and say, whoa, woo-wee. On your deathbed, you're going to go, whew, I did it. I put 100% in. Every moment, am I putting 100% in, because I am everything and everything I do affects everybody else. I have a big responsibility. So I've witnessed this at least twice recently. I know I've experienced this before and didn't really know what it was. You are the thing, you are the energy that we don't see and the energy that we do see. So I was in a meditation and I actually was experiencing my body meditating, and I also experienced myself in another room with two light beings looking at me in the living room meditating, having a conversation. And I don't remember the conversation, because I just caught the end of it when my body became aware of it, of me being out of body. I was saying to them, it was sort of like a fun game. I think I'm going to give up fear. You probably think I don't have it, right? It'll show up once in a while. I don't really do anything with it. But giving it up completely is a different ballgame than having it and not having it, you know, have it trigger anything. So I said, I think I'm going to give up fear. I went, what? And then I was back in my body. I went, who was I talking to? There's these two light beings. I was having a full-blown conversation. I caught myself having a whole-blown conversation with my mother right after she died. And when I woke up, I was aware that somebody was hugging me, which was weird. I mean, physically hugging me. I was actually awake. And I laid there and just experienced it. And I heard myself talking to my mother. I heard that conversation, so I must have been on the other side talking. So because you're not cognizant of these things doesn't mean it's not going on. We think, well, I don't experience that. I don't remember that. That's the whole purpose. If you knew all this stuff, it would totally change the game. That's the beauty of being ignorant. We're all ignorant on some level. We still don't have the answers. You're not going to. You don't need to. You just have to experience what you're experiencing here and raise the frequency of the planet and yourself. You are everything. Don't think for a minute that every thought isn't affecting everything. Not the planet, not the universe. The universes of beyond our imagination is all affected, because it's you. It's like you having a thought here affects your whole body, your heart rate, all these other things. That's how it works. It's beyond human comprehension. So people are like, how can I be part of everything? So when you take responsibility before being a part of all of this, being the one, you affect change, you empower yourself. Right? You empower yourself, because now you're saying, I actually can change not only my life and my reality, but others. And not having to control everything in the way you think, because that's the ego, but saying, okay, here's how I want my life to evolve. I want to be better. I want to be prosperous. I want to be healthy. And things will come to you to make that happen, because you are a part of it. It's already you making decisions on the other side to give yourself the things. You don't have to have those answers here, because you will send you what you need, even though this might be thinking something, I need this, and it's on the other side going, no, you're ready to go to this, so we're going to send you this challenge, because that's going to take you to here. I think you're ready for this. I really do. I think you can handle this. It's like, whoa. Landria, I've got a headache right now thinking about this stuff. Don't think. Just say, everything I do, believe, think, feel is affecting everything on in the universe. Everything. Wow. I better get my act together, right? Ooh. What am I thinking about? Just what I can earn or this and that? What if I focused on something really awesome that was great for me and everybody else? But it has to come from your heart, which means when you meditate and you connect to the one that you are, then you're disconnecting from the material world that's not going to make you happy anyways. Is that FedEx coming for me? I think so. You're whole, perfect, strong, powerful, loving, harmonious, and happy. You are a beautiful, perfect light being. Prosperous, healthy, it all exists, all these realities. You're one. Everything that's ever been, will be, can be, is all existing at the same time, all happening, every reality. Get to pull what you want into this reality. Embrace whatever the universe is giving you according to what you ordered. That's going to make you a better, more useful, loving, awesome person. That you already are. It's all a fun, I know some people don't like it when I say game, but it is. So have fun with it. You get to create it. You get to create the ending of your play. I look forward to seeing you on the other side one day, by the way. We're all going to have a good laugh about this. Share my videos. Subscribe. Let's start to send these messages out. This is my mission in life. I do this because I love you and I have a big job to do, and I plan on doing it till the day I die, and then I'm going to go off and do even more awesome things. Oh, exciting! Namaste.